Yes, sir.
Okay, so first of all, I congratulate Columbia Institute of Pharmacy to organize such a wonderful STPP, Staff Development Program. And I am thankful to your chief patron, Kishore Jadwani, sir, and patron of this seminar, Harjit Singh Hura, sir, and principal, Dr. Amit Roy, sir, and coordinator, Dr. Shiv Shankar Shukla, and co-coordinator, Dr. Ravind Kumar Pandey, and Mr. Gunjan Kalyani, and Mr. Swati Dubey, Ms. Swati Pandey, for organizing a just short-term training program. And I am also submitting my gratitude to Professor Swarnalata Sarab, madam, and Dr. Shailen Sarab, sir, jo mere guru hai, jinke badolat aaj hum, jo bhi humne attend kiya hai, aaj unhi ki badolat hai. So, just my topic regarding that is a future trends in research methodology for drug discovery and development. As we know, drug discovery is a multifaceted process which involves identification of drug chemicals and therapeutically useful in the treatment and management of a disease conditions. And I am also thankful to COVID-19, which are just created in such a situation where accelerated drug discovery has been happened, and as a result we are then seeing that COVID-19 vaccines are available, and it's just beyond the limit of FDA and other. So COVID-19 ko ek tarah se bahut jo user ek tarah se technology enabled bhi kiya hai aur ek aapka उससे भी जोड़ा है कि आप कैसे रिसर्च करी जाती है और कैसे एक्सेलरेटेड रिसर्च करी जाती है, या जो भी आपके विद इन अ शॉर्ट पीरियड 1 ईयर वैक्सीन डेवलप हुआ, तो ये भी एक एग्जांपल है. और जहां अपन ड्रग डिस्कवरी की बात करें कि इट टेक्स अबाउट 10 to 12 ईयर्स और आपके सामने रिजल्ट है कि हाँ, आपके पास रिजल्ट है कि आपको विद इन 1 ईयर आपको वैक्सीन मिल गई. सो अगर टॉक अबाउट द फ्यूचर ट्रेंड इन रिसर्च एंड मेथोडोलॉजी फॉर ड्रग डिस्कवरी, तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई टारगेट सिलेक्शंस. टारगेट सिलेक्शंस एंड टारगेट सिलेक्शंस में भी है बायोकेमिकल क्लास ऑफ ड्रग टारगेटिंग, like G protein coupling coupled receptor around 45%, and enzymes targeting अपन करे तो 28% वो helpful करता है. Hormones and factors around 11%, and ion channels around 5%, and nuclear receptors around 20%. So first we have to do drug discovery. As we know, there are a lot of spend of money is utilized for the drug discovery, around 900 millions to $2 billion it requires, around 10 to 15 years. And out of 5,000 to 10,000 molecules, we just target one for the selection of a new drug application. So just first of all, we have to find out target selections, which target we are utilizing for the particular development of any new drug, like G protein, enzymes, hormones and factors, ion channels, nuclear receptor, then cellular and genetic targets, or we have to study about genomics. Means that is a study of genes and function, then understand the structure of genome, mapping gene, yeah, sequencing the DNA, and human around 3 billion nucleotides, sequencing probably encode around 35,000 to 50,000 genes. Then proteomics is also required, like protein produced by a species. So India is often referred to as a pharmacy of the world, not without reason. And the third largest pharmaceutical market in the world by volume, India supplies a bulk of generic drugs globally, not just to underdeveloped countries, but also to US and UK. And also India supplies almost 40% of the total American generic drug demand and addresses as much as 25% of the total drug demand in the UK. COVID, as we seen in COVID, near Ratlam, Ipca plant was not US FDA approved, but as per demand, they supply hydroxychloroquine to US. So our new drug development, supply demand also based on the need, current need. And India's pharmaceutical sector also fulfill over half of the total global demand for vaccines. Next slide, please. New drug applications or biological license applications are reviewed comprehensively before approval. And the drug performance is resubmitted to regulatory agency for post-marketing studies. And the overreaching goal is to bring more efficient and safer treatment to the patient as quickly as possible after through medical evaluation. If we talk about the quality of medicines, means it should fulfill four requirements, that is the identity, strength, purity, and safety. So there are all our DP, USP, and IPR concerned. We are focused on these four parameters. So the main ultimately goal is to provide a quality medicines to the patient. Next slide. Drug discovery is a long-term commitment, and Indian companies have traditionally been low investor in R&D due to the high risk, high cost involved. And at the same time, paucity of strong industry academia ties also act as a hurdle to the realization of India's true scientific potential. So we have to make a strong industry academia relationship so we can transfer our research innovation to the industrial level, or where we can it means we can technology transfer our research to the
Sir, you are not audible. Sir, is there any network issue?
कनेक्शन बता
रहा हूँ सॉरी फॉर द इंटरप्शन नेटवर्क कनेक्शन इश्यू था थोड़ा
यस सर
तो आवाज
जी सर जी सर ऑडिबल यस सर यू आर ऑडिबल नाउ
हेलो
यस सर
हेलो हाँ इट रिक्वायर्ड मल्टी डाइमेंशनल एफर्ट्स नेक्स्ट स्लाइड
यस सर
Government latest R&D thrust, government launching a dedicated policy plan to address the R&D deficit in pharma sector. And series of report last year had suggested that Department of Pharmaceutical was planning to create a separate department for R&D and was looking at having a dedicated R&D head in place of push for discovery of commercially viable new molecule. And this policy push when comes to friction will definitely help channelize the scattered innovation efforts and give them better directions. Next. This is the drug development process where in vitro and in vivo testing and data review just start with a basic research, then early discovery, then preclinical, then clinical development. It requires phase one, phase two, phase three, then FDA review your NDA application, then finally post-marketing surveillance. Next. So these are the various phases: discovery and development, preclinical research, clinical development, FDA review. So overall, here five steps are required for any drug development process. Next. So these are the early discovery where we have to identify a target identification and validation. Target identification, just like whether it is a G protein coupled receptor identification, the enzyme identification, the hormone factors identification, or ion channel identification, or your nuclear receptor identification. Then preclinical study involves in vitro, in vivo, ex vivo, ADME. Means when we have to find out the hit to lead compound out of thousands, or we have to just find out the hit to lead compounds for the development. Next. So there are step one, first discovery and development. And historically, drugs were mostly found by identifying active ingredient from traditional medicines or purchased by chance. And afterward, classical pharmacology was used to investigate chemical libraries, including small molecules, natural products, or plant extract, and find those with therapeutic effect. These particular library will help to find out a very good compound for the drug research. Next slide. Since human DNA was sequenced, reverse pharmacology has found remedies to existing diseases through testing. And today, drug discovery involves screening hits, then medicinal chemistry and optimization of hits to reduce potential drug side effects and efficacy or potency metabolic stability like high blood and oral biology are also improved in this step of drug development process. Next. First, we have to identify a target identification and validation. Target identification find a gene or protein that plays a significant role in the disease. When generally we have targeted delivery system, which are now currently used in a cancer, where we found out a particular target where the drug are attached with a particular receptor. So this particular target, it may be a protein target or it may be a gene target where our drug will bind and show its therapeutic. So target identification, that is a potential parameter for the drug discovery, and target are efficacious and usable as drug and capable of meeting clinical and commercial requirements. Researchers use disease association or bioactive molecules, cell-based models, protein interactions, signaling pathway analysis, and functional analysis of genes to validate targets, or in vitro genetic manipulations, or antibodies, and chemical genomics. And hit discovery process means following target validation, compound screening assays are developed. Next. So first we have to find out target. Then assay development and screening assays are test systems that evaluate the effect of new drug candidate at the cellular, molecular, and biochemical levels. High throughput screening. This high throughput screening, just HTS, uses robotics data processing control software, yeah, liquid handling devices and sensitive detectors to rapidly conduct millions of the pharmacological, chemical and genetic tests, eliminating hours of painstaking testing in scientists. So this high throughput screening machines will accelerate our the drug discovery process. Next. Then that is an important parameter, that is a hit to lead, means small molecule hits from HTs are evaluated and optimized in a limited way to a lead compound, and this compound then move on the lead optimization process, means out of 1000 or out of 10,000 after library we have to identify hit compound, yeah, hit to lead, and lead optimization means the lead optimization discovered in the H2L process, means hit to lead process, are synthesized and modified to improve potency and reduce side effects. Lead optimization conduct experimental testing using animal efficacy models and ADMEs tool designing the drug candidate. It will help in a bioinformatics tool is also bioinformatics. Next. What is active pharmaceutical ingredient means are they are biologically active ingredient in a drug candidate produce effects, and all drugs are made up of the API or APIs and excipients. High potency active pharmaceutical ingredients where molecules are effective at much smaller dose, as we can say, so potent drug level than the standard. Next. They are classified based on the toxicity or pharmacological potency and occupational exposure limits, and used in a development involving more than 10 steps. And the drug discovery process ends when one lead compound is found for a drug candidate. The process of drug development starts. So first stage means target identification and then selection of a hit compound or lead compound. Then the drug development process will start. Next. Step two, the preclinical research, where drug development begins with the preclinical research to determine the efficacy and safety of the drug. Researchers determine the following about the drug, like PMA profile, informations, or potential benefits and mechanism of actions. And best dosage and administration route, then side effect. And so during development, yeah, during preclinical research, we have to know about the ADME profile, then potential benefit and mechanism of actions, then best dosage and administration route and side effect. So all of these factors we also have to take account for preclinical research. Next. Then effect of gender, race, or ethnicity group, then interaction with other treatments, then effectiveness compared to similar drug, then preclinical trial test on the non-human subjects for efficacy, toxicity, and pharmacokinetic information. And these trials are conducted by scientists in vitro or in vivo with unrestricted doses. Next. Then absorption, distribution, disposition, metabolism, and excretion. ADME, that is a pharmacokinetic process of measuring the way the new drug affects the body. And ADME involves mathematical description of the, as we already studied in a biopharmaceutical, where different type of models, one compartment, two compartment, and three compartment model, and there are various equations which measure the half-life, volume of distribution, and then protein binding, and etc. So proof of principle or proof of concept, we also utilize proof of principles are studies that are successful in preclinical trial and early safety testing, and proof of concept terminology is used almost interchangeably with POP in drug discovery and development process. And successful POP and POC studies lead to program advancement to the phase two studies of doses. Next. Next slide. Then in vivo, in vitro, and ex vivo assays. So there are these three-step type of studies are conducted on the whole living organism or cell, including animals and humans, or using non-living organism or tissue extract, where in vivo clinical research examples are the development of new drug using mice, rat and dog models, or any compartment models. Then in vitro is research conducting in a laboratory, or ex vivo using animal cell, like generally in cancer or other diseases, we perform the ex vivo, like animal cells or tissue from a non-living animals. Next. Examples of ex vivo research assays are including effective cancer treatment agents, measurement of tissue properties like physical, thermal, electrical, and optical, and realistic modeling for new surgical process. And in an ex vivo assay, a cell is always used as a basis for small explant culture that provides dynamic control and sterile environment. Next. Now, this particular in silico assay, in silico assays are test system or biological experiment performed on a computer or via computer simulation that we studied in a chemistry purpose. Chemistry persons utilize various CAD analysis and computer aided drug designing system, and these are expected to become increasingly popular with the ongoing improvement in computational power and behavioral understanding of molecular dynamics and cell biology. And now we are also utilizing artificial intelligence, where new technology are generally helpful for the development of drug delivery system. Then next one is drug delivery. New drug delivery methods include oral, topical, or membrane, or IV, or inhalations. So thus, drug delivery systems are used for targeted delivery or controlled release of new drug or any type of delivery system. Where physiological barrier in animal or human body may prevent drugs from reaching the targeted area or releasing when they should. The goal is to prevent the drug from interacting with the healthy tissues while still being effective. Next. Next slide. Then formulation optimization and improving bioavailability. Formulation optimization is ongoing throughout preclinical and clinical stages, where we also utilize various type of optimization modules. So we can select a better drug according to their results. So it ultimately it will reduce the cost of drug and it ensures that are delivered to the proper place at the right time and in the right concentration. Next. Step that is a clinical development, where complexity of study design, associated cost and implementation issues. So associated cost and implementation issues may affect the trial carried out during this phase. Trial must be safe and efficacious and be completed under the drug development budget, using methodology to ensure the drug word as well as possible for intended purpose. And this rigorous process must be set up correctly and enroll many volunteers to be effective. Next. Clinical trial dose escalation, single ascending and multiple dose studies. So proper dosing determines medication effectiveness, and clinical trial examine dose escalation, single ascending and multiple dose study to determine the best patient doses. So phase one, that is a healthy volunteer study. And this will be the first time the drug is tested on humans, and less than 100 volunteers will help researchers assess the safety and pharmacokinetic absorption, metabolic and elimination effect on the body, as well as any side effect for the safe doses range. Next. Then clinical trials, dose escalation. Then phase two and phase three study in patient population. Phase two drug safety and efficacy is in an additional 100 to 500 patients who may receive a placebo or a standard drug previously used as a treatment. Then analysis of optimal dose strength help create a schedule which adverse event and risks are recorded. Phase third enrolls around 1,000 to 5,000 patients, LM billing, medication labeling, and instruction for proper drug use. And third trials require extensive collaboration, organization, and independent ethical committee, that is IESC, or an institutional review board, coordination and regulation in anticipation of full-scale production following drug approval. So this particular phase 2 and phase 3 study are required for the drug development process. Next. Then biological samples collection, then storage, and their shipment. So during clinical trial, biological samples are collected, stored, and shipped from the testing sites according to global standard and regulation. The transport containers of biological sample may include dry ice packs, yeah, other temperature stabilizing method. Different requirements apply to different type of biological samples. Next. Then pharmacodynamic biomarkers. These PD biomarkers are molecular indicators of the drug effective on the target human area and link drug regimen and biological responses. This data can help select a rational combination of targeted agent and optimized drug regimen and schedules. Rationally and hypothesis testing power are increased throughout the use of PD endpoint in human trials. Next. Then pharmacokinetic analysis that is an experimental trial that determine the theory of how a new drug behaves in the human body and the volume of distribution, clearance, and terminal half-life are defined through this compartment modeling. Then bioanalytical methods development and validation. Bioanalytical method detect analysis and metabolites such as drug or biomarkers in biologically human sample to determine drug efficacy and safety. And their method development as per the ICH guidelines or other any government guidelines where we have to validate the bioanalytical method or we have to validate a particular developed method. Next. Drug and metabolite stability in biological samples. Stability that is important in determining human drug efficacy and biological samples are required. Drug and drug metabolites are susceptible to degradation, which can lower drug concentration over the life of the drug. So we have to propose a stability study. Then blood, plasma, urine, and feces sample analysis for drug and metabolites. So biological samples used in clinical trial include blood, plasma, urine, and feces to determine and analyze various properties and effects of the drug and its metabolites on human. Next slide. Patient protection like GCP or HIP and adverse event reporting. So human patient must always be protected during clinical trials. And good clinical practice and the Health Insurance Probability and Accountability Act and adverse event reporting to institutional ethical committee regulates and ensures their safety. Next. Then FDA review. There is a regulatory approval timeline. The new drug regulatory approval timeline may be standard, fast track, breakthrough, accelerated approval, or priority or review depending on its application and necessity for patient. And if standard or a priority review is required, the approval timeline may be up to an year fast track, breakthrough or accelerated approval, as we shown an example of COVID-19 vaccine, that is the accelerated approval process where we shortcut a particular clinical process and we require a fast result, so this accelerated approval may occur sooner. Next. Then IND applications are submitted to the FDA before starting clinical trial. And if clinical trials are ready to be conducted and the FDA has not responded negatively about the drug, developer may start the trials. Then NDA, ANDA, and BLA applications. and NDA abbreviated new drug application or BLA is submitted to FDA. After clinical trial demonstrate drug safety and efficacy, and the FDA review study data and decide whether to grant approval or not. Additional research or an expert advisory panel may be required before a final decision is made. Next. That is the thrust area where orphan drugs, as we know, there are more than 6,000 orphan diseases are available in worldwide, like Gaucher disease, yeah, Wilson disease, where that is a rare disease. That's why it's called an orphan drug. So orphan drug is intended to treat disease so rare that financially sponsors are unwilling to develop it under standard marketing condition. And these drugs may not be approved quickly or at all because only 1% or 2% patients are suffering from these orphan diseases. So accelerated approval, new drug may be granted accelerated. New drug grant next. NDA application and NDA orphan. So new drug may be granted accelerated approval if there is a strong evidence of positive impact on a surrogate endpoint instead of evidence of impact on actual clinical benefit the drug provides. Expedition of the approval means the medication can help treat severe or life-threatening conditions. So this accelerated approval, jo abhi COVID-19 mein chala hai aapka, that is accelerated approval process. Next. Reason for drug failure. New drug applications may fail for a variety of reasons, including toxicity or efficacy or pH properties or bioabilities or inadequate drug performance. Then toxicity, if the toxicity of new drug is too high in humans or animal patients, the drug may be rejected due to safety concerns about its following manufacturing. Then efficacy, if a new drug efficacy is not high enough or evidence is inconclusive, the FDA may reject it. Next. Pharmacokinetic properties or bioavailability, PK properties, or poor bioavailability due to low aqueous solubility or high first pass metabolism may also cause a drug to fail FDA review. PK causes of drug failure include inadequate action duration and unanticipated human drug interactions or inadequate drug performance if the new drug performs the desired function but only at a shallow level. The FDA may reject the application in favor of a formulation that performs better. Next one. That is a post-marketing monitoring, that is a step 5. Following drug approval and manufacturing, the FDA required drug companies to monitor the safety of its drug using the FDA adverse event report system. And this FEARs help FDA implement its post-marketing safety surveillance program. Through this program, manufacturers, healthy personnel, and consumers report problem with the approved drug. Next. So, due to this COVID-19, I am just suggesting there are 10 future trends that will matter for pharma in 2021. Next one. First, the pandemic has forced rethink of how to manage a chemical trials, manage a clinical trial and treat patients in hospitals and their homes. So at the breakneck speed of the vaccines developed in 2020 could potentially lead to accelerated timeline for other therapeutics in the future. Next one. First, pressure will mount to unblock clinical trial bottlenecks. Means the COVID-19 pandemic has understood the need to optimize clinical trial processes as we have developed within 1 year. So it need to be optimized clinical trial process. While the public-private initiative operations work speed has won public attention for its ability to speed vaccine development and distribution. And it also focuses new attention on common water clean in the clinical trial process. Means that is a question mark कि इट रिक्वायर्स 10 टू 12 इयर्स फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर मॉलिक्यूल कम्स इनटू द मार्केट बट एसबीआरसी ने कोविड 19 वैक्सीन तो वेयर विद इन 1 ईयर वी गॉट अ वी परफॉर्म ऑल द क्लिनिकल ट्रायल्स एंड अ प्रोडक्ट इज लॉन्च इन द मार्केट फॉर द सो your clinical trial is also depends on the requirement and patient need. Next. Second, global decentralized study will become a standard clinical research. As we've seen that the partner, India partner and US partner for the development of new vaccines. So it requires a globally decentralized study. So we can speed our clinical research and we can speed our drug development process. And this decentralized approach will support ongoing studies affect the COVID-19 lockdown and studies that launch in 2021. Then sponsored and CRO will continue to be eager to bounce back and accelerate the drug development process after significant delays caused by the pandemic. So in 2020, technology enabled clinical research with a more global focus will become a standard clinical design approach. Next one. Then radiomics will gain ground in drug development and clinical trial. As we've seen, there are various pathological means radiomics like PET analysis or MRI analysis and sonography, and they will help in the identification of target and development of new molecules. So precision imaging analytic technology known as radiomics will see increased adoption in 2021 and will be incorporated into a drug development strategy and clinical trial management. And these analytics will enable drug developer to gain deeper insight from medical image that previously capable, driving accelerated therapy development and greater personalization of treatment and the discovery of new biomarker that will enhance the clinical decision making and treatment. So radiomics will also help in the development of drug and also trigger the speed of drug development process. Next. Life science companies will turn to NLP to process mountains of text-based data. Means natural language processing has long-fold potential for the life science field, given the industry reliance on the text-based data in the form of clinical record or scientific papers or pharmaceutical companies, call center transcription, and so forth. So the proliferation of life science data on a social media exacerbate the challenge of integrating the making sense of diverse data set, robotic process automation that has gained traction in other sectors will continue making inroads in healthcare to reduce the need for tedious routine tasks. Next one. Then priority for drug development will continue to shift. Next year, drug development priority will continue to evolve in meaningful ways. The industry will see continued growth in research for drug and understanding of rare disease. As the consumer or drug entering in the market increasing along with pricing and market access pressure, there will be progress in pharmaceutical companies' ability to make value-based assessment based on real-world data to the assess product, brand, and so forth. Next one. Then digital therapeutics will increasingly complement drug. Advanced analytics and machine learning will streamline remote patient monitoring, allowing the physician to optimally titrate their drug doses. And this continuous monitoring and clinical oversight are especially helpful for conditions such as heart failure, in which a very low percentage of patients are on guideline-directed therapies and only about 1% receive target dose of medicines. Next. Visibility grows across the life science value chain. The Pfizer, BioNTech, SARS-CoV vaccines requirement to be stored at minus 70 degrees centigrade has highlighted the cold temperature control supply chain importance. and time constant for precise patient treatment driven by the cold chain nature of costlier drug with the time and out of refrigeration makes requirement more astringent for the traceability of the chain of identify and custody along with the entire supply chain. Next one. More precise inventory management. Inventory management will become more tightly focused. If you are making a therapeutic for one specific customer, the supply chain becomes a size one. You need to order just enough supply ingredient and they have to be delivered at just the right time and right place. Next one. Increase focus on precision dosing and monitoring of specialty drugs. As the focus continue on reducing harm from the ADS, there will be a decrease in precision dosing and monitoring of specialty drugs, especially for those with narrow therapeutic index and wide variation in a drug response. So pharmaceutical company will play early emphasis on precision dosing during clinical trials related to drug development, and it is a fundamental shift in continuous support to ultimately improve care and reduce healthcare costs. COVID-19 will continue to surprise. For all the brain power and data models researchers have used for model the COVID-19, the pandemic continued to surprise experts. The unprecedented nature of the pandemic make it challenge to anticipate what impact the virus will have next years. There are so many unknowns. Next one. Faster time to market for drug discovery, big data and early stage experiment using new technology are helping sustainability, lower time and cost in bringing new drug formulation to market. The entire research and the development cycle spanning data management, clinical trial and testing are how so technology oriented that pharma companies are increasingly onboarding health tech partners and tech startup in the journey to drug discovery. Next one. Then digitization and automation is a paperless process and also ensure that quality process were robust and scalable with minimal scope for human error. It ensured cGMP compliance in the manufacturing process. Besides, robotic technology have been reducing manufacturing downtime and substantially reducing product wastage. Next one. Automation has curbed human intervention associated with increased risk of contamination as well as variability. The developed and researchers are integrating their knowledge to develop and have common access to phase appropriate process developed and bioassay series, removing manufacturing bottlenecks, reducing their cost of goods, and perform preparing for commercial readiness in advance. Next one. Biological includes genetic susceptibility and pharmacogenetic, epigenetics and genomes. Instead of developing medicines like small molecules and generics, which start at the point when a disease disrupts the normal healthy life of an individual, the move towards biological, which studies how diseases are expressed or contracted through genetic susceptibility or prevented through genetic resistance, have a new and rapidly growing interest in pharmacogenetics, epigenetics and genomes. Example, COVID-19 research papers have primarily focused on the study of the virus at the protein level and how they interact with RNA and DNA. Next one. Connected virtual and self-monitoring in patient care. The advent of connected device have a new trend in self-monitoring without having to physically visit a clinic or a doctor. Instead, they have the necessary equipment available at their home at a fraction of the cost for most self-centering needs. The reading are transmitted to a centrally console of the monitoring healthcare provider or doctor for their review and analysis. And diagnostic healthcare is fast moving towards such connected devices, and the internet providing the first level diagnostic followed by a prognosis and final review by an expert doctor before actual prescription. Next one. And this is empowering both patient and doctor to be connected virtually and has swept their whole system for healthier integrator and aggregators, bringing experts and patient on a self-monitoring virtual healthcare platform. Government across the globe are realizing how such connected healthcare system are not only more flexible but also extremely efficient. Diagnosis and prognosis for a review by consulting expert doctors have already gained sustainable traction even in hospital clinics where the number of patients is high and connected healthcare is going to be a new normal from 2021. Next one. Global collaboration in compliance and regulatory condition. COVID-19 has unshared in collaboration and not completion amongst each country pharmaceutical regulatory body. And through the US government has voiced its displeasure with the WHO. This global collaboration in healthcare, both researchers and compliance, is only going to get more deeply entrenched moving forward. Regulatory bodies like US FDA and EMA are going to strengthen the WHO in its way of working. And automation software for common standard and compliance are going to be universally implemented since it impacts the human body at large. As the world rapidly takes to the convenience of healthcare solutions through technology, the pharma industry is presented with the challenge to ensure that their workforce is adept at addressing this demand and can keep up with the speed of the adoption by customer. Pharma companies need to upskill and train their personnel in the latest development and way of working with customer at various touch points. Next one. We do not just need to scale up invention in R&D, but also need to incentive entrepreneurship in biotechnology. Untrained human resources and lack of industry readiness among science graduates need to be bridged by creating close industry academia ties, making pedagogy more relevant to the industry and boosting the system of academic research for students. In the pharma industry itself need to diversify its research focus to cover a wide variety of diseases, including neglected tropical diseases and non-communicable diseases. I am thankful to chief patron or patron, principal, coordinator, co-coordinator, and all the committee member of Columbia Institute of Pharmacy for organizing this short-term training program and future training research methodology for drug discovery and development. Once again, thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your profound knowledge with us. If any participant have any question, they may ask.
Any questions?
Okay. Okay, thank you, sir. It will be a great pleasure for us to listen to you in our future trends. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
So our today's session successfully completed. So we'll meet tomorrow as per the schedule. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Okay.